Hello everyone, this is Roxas1359, welcome back to Let's Play One Piece Unlimited Cruise Episode 1. Last time, we ended up fighting the Drum King Wapple, managing to dethrone him yet again, and unlock some new GP. In this episode, we're going to be exploring around the island. Now, the reason why we're not completing the island as of yet is because we still have a few things that we have to do, and I need to build up some things for my GP. So, one good thing is this island right here is pretty good with the rubber fruit, actually. So you can get quite a few of those. I need a mad puppet drop one of his maps eventually. Because one of the things I'm missing out greatly on is a map. I guess I can get some nectar around here. Oh, I got hit by the guillotine. It was a little... Or my mistake, the swinging pendulums of doom, as they were put inside of Looney Tunes Back in Action. A movie that I actually don't think is as bad as other people think, but then again, I am an odd one. So, let us get a bunch of nectar, because nectar can be used for a lot of GP purposes. So, as you can see, we're getting pretty high up there in the GP, ladies and gentlemen. If you're wondering what the cap is for GP, for a lot of them, in fact, for all of them, it's going to be a 10 maximum. That's for fighting. If you fight all of the bosses in the game, you'll get all GP but the gold to at least, I believe, 7 or... No, you'll get the gold to a max GP of 6. While for everything else, you'll get it to 10 by the end of the game. Anyway, we have another chest right here. I need to steal a piece of cloth from this gosh darn guy. Because what I want more than anything is that piece of cloth. Because it's a pain to get them. Steal it! Come on, please! Please, Nami, can you steal it for me? Pretty please, with sugar on top. I guess that's a no. So, better go and kill the Marines. What am I doing? I could use just Luffy. He's got more... No, I should use Zoro, because he's still... Out of all my characters, he's still the least leveled up. And this always seems to happen to me. I don't know why I don't like using Zoro. Because, for all intents and purposes, he's stronger than Baruch, and he's still pretty good to use. Either way, kill all them, and back here there's a chest, so open it up. And you found some frozen meat, which can be used to make the pirate's lunchbox. This is a precious commodity. It's hard to get a hold of meat. I guess I'll make the usual lunch. And we also need a toad that looks like a mammoth. Well, I know where that is, and they're only available on this island, actually. In fact, you're gonna have to go up there if we have to be able to beat this island. Right, so we got a bunch of mud puppets around here that have all transformed into Marines. Unfortunately, I cannot kill them as mud puppets and get the map that I wanted. I really want that map because Frankie is fully leveled up but has no specials, and that is because he can only get one of his specials through item development. At the same time, same with Chopper, it was only through compounding that he could get his other one. Actually, no, it was the only way he could get both of his. And I believe for Frankie, in order to get his other special, you're going to need to have your one special leveled up. But that takes care of them, so let's go over this way. And that's right, I have some rubber fruits that I can feed to Gabuti. Pretty much this part, I'm just going to be feeding Gabuti a lot. Now, you can use marble to fill up the white GP, which can be found in abundance in other places. I'll use the radishes. I have more than enough healing items, so might as well fill all those up as well. So we're already doing pretty good. I've got quite a few ice fragments. And we're going to use one of our golden eggs that I got from a flying penguin for an area that's coming up. Get rid of the scrap metal. Kuwagatas would work for that. Apples would work for red, but we're going to need the bamboo, which is why I'm not touching it. Because if we go over this way, we got a big old butterfly. This butterfly can be used... Oh, wow, this one's actually really big. No! No! That was a giant one! Curse you, mud puppets! Curse you! And you didn't even drop a map! Darn it. That was a big butterfly. Okay, it's bouncing around here somewhere. No, come back! There we go. I can use that to feed the Gabbity in a bit. But go over this way. And we have an area to where we can build another ladder. So we can build one right here.
Ow!
All right. So let's build ourselves another one of the things. Ladder. I can't speak today. Anyway, this one is plot required, so make sure that you make this one. Well, you kind of have to. It's the only way you can continue, but here we have our new ladder. This is plot required because to get to the next boss, we're actually going to need to power up our vacuum to be able to suck up poison walls. Something that I ended up pointing out earlier we would soon have. Okay, medical herbs, that's nice and all, but I wanted maps! Anyway, since we're also up here, we can also grab ourselves the map from the, well, the treasure from Pirate Map 3, which is over here. So, hit on the floor right here. Open this up, and you get a vision dial. So yes, we have the vision dial, which I believe is just a plot item that you can grab later on. You also have the ability to grab some radishes right here if you need them. The only reason you want to grab them is for a good dish that you could increase, I believe, health and GP. But if you look right over here, we have ourselves another one of these. Now this one right here, this is one of the hidden boss areas. As you can see, our GP is too low. This is one of the hidden bosses that we're going to be fighting later, and in fact, I find that one to be one of the easier hidden bosses to fight. We're going to be fighting the hidden bosses soon enough, so no worries. And after you beat each one, you'll gain a new gold GP. Anyway, one of the spawning points of the flying penguin is actually right here. Sometimes the flying penguin can spawn right here. If it's not right here, it's back at the beginning of the stage between two ice pillars or between another one of the ice cliffs. But, oh, we haven't seen these guys since Island... Oh, my! I got comboed! Wow! I'm impressed! That got me stuck! And that was rather hilarious. Guess what? I can do the same thing to you guys. No, 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 no. I'm out! All right, there we go. Now I'm in a safe spot right here. Right. Oh. Oh. Oh, no. I've never seen the... Okay, there we go. I managed to save him from getting eaten by the floor. That I've never seen before. But not only that, we got these guys back. Right, and who is it? Ah, dang it, I was trying to get a break rush, then I could kill all of them. Anyway, this area right here, this is the only place to where you can find the mammoth toads, as what was mentioned for the pirate's lunchbox. In an easy location. They are right here, as you can see. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm going to kill all the little robots. Or I believe they were called, they weren't called Machina. What did the manga end up calling them? Because these were in a little side story that Oda usually ends up doing. But let us grab our nets and go and get ourselves a toad frog. Or a mammoth toad, I believe it's called. Yep, mammoth toad. So, that is a mammoth toad for you. And now we are going to get ourselves a golden apple. They take a long time to respawn, so watch out. But when they do, you can get quite a few of them. So, Mammoth Toad. We need one more, and we can make the pirate lunchbox, which would be nice. I want to use my vines for later, but we're going to use... We're just going to use one of them, because we are close enough, and technically speaking... No, I want to hold on to the pure iron ore. Right? So, bitter grass, medical grass, and then at the same time, if you go right here, dig into the wall, you'll get some frozen meat. So this is where you can get frozen meat, because I think this thing's actually a giant mammoth. And the frozen meat will respawn, so let's actually look. Let's actually use that. Yes, it is a giant mammoth. I always wondered what that is. It's a giant mammoth toad. That explains why you can find them right here. But I'm pretty sure I shouldn't be ignoring this chest that's right here. So open it up, and we get a mysterious gadget. But now that we have our mysterious gadget, I'm going to power up a certain little device. It'll have more suction than ever, which would make us the power vacuum cleaner, which will allow us to basically be able to get through poison walls. This is the only item that... No, actually, I believe this item does carry over into it. And it is the only way in which you're going to be able to continue on with the island. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to go back to the Thousand Sunny in order to make it. Now what I'm going to do right here is go over here and punch all these mud puppets. And of course I got no map. Is it so hard to just get a map so then I could get Frankie's stupid special already? Ooh, butterfly. Perfect, I can use this thing to fill up my gold GP. And... There we go. Yep. That's a big old butterfly. So let us now... Not status. Breaking points. The butterfly. It's a short amount, but it gives you enough. And at the same time, I need to use more of my ice. All right. And why don't I suck up everything around here, get some more nectar... Then I can get myself more GP. That's pretty much what this episode is in its entirety, ladies and gentlemen. This is what I usually do off screen, is I farm for GP. Sometimes I'll go to other islands, because it makes it a lot easier if I do. And in this case, I just wanted to show it off, but... Mud puppets, mud puppets. Yes! Thank you! That's map fragment one. Before we end off this part, we're going to be going to grab that where the treasure is, because I know exactly where that is. I've been waiting for it, and these mud puppets normally would have dropped it for me by now. But we also need to go and find out other locations. So I'm going to be ignoring all these mud puppets, and we're going to go down this way. Now, you got to watch out around this spot, because this is where slowdown becomes very apparent inside this game, because there are too many enemies on screen at once, and it gets pretty ridiculous. It gets pretty ridiculous. Okay, here's a fourth spawning point for one of the flying penguins. This is what they look like right here, so let's see if we can catch one. There we go, managed to get it. You can't use the flying penguins for any development items or for anything else, but they are just there to shit out golden eggs for you. So there are four spawning points for them, it seems that. Oh no! Ooh. Oh my! I got scared for a second that I got caught back in another loop. Right? Let's get rid of everyone. Right now. Because this is getting annoying. Alright, so that deals with that. Now let's go upward. How much time are we at? We're at 34 minutes. Okay. That means we're about halfway to where I ended off the episode last time. Oh my god, this slowdown is ridiculous. Let's break this. I believe you're going to need 5 ice shards as well for the next boss. So grab some ice shards. They're really easy. You can just dig into the ground, grab some if you need it. But grab that one. Go up over this way. Slowdown's gone, but now the slowdown's about to be back. And welcome to the main top part of the island, ladies and gentlemen. If you look over that way, you can see our other stone right there. That's going to require a lot of GP, but we're also going to have a bunch of marines around here, which is why it's so annoying to deal with all this. They cause a lot of slowdown. Remember, you also need to catch an ice beetle, which there are many trees around in this area that ice beetles will spawn on. It's specifically put all the way for there. Unfortunately, I didn't catch one beforehand. That would have been very helpful. But we have one of the lovely marine guys who hopefully will be nice enough to drop the cloth for me, because that'll be used to make one of Usopp's specials. I guess not. All right. Is it on this tree? Nope. Okay. So let's go down and see what our requirements are for the boss for this one. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a different boss, so you're going to want to prepare up for items. All right, so I am missing 3 green GP. You're going to need 15 ice shards. Okay, so I was a little bit off by that, by about 10. And you're going to need an ice beetle. Ice beetle, that's probably the harder one to get. Getting ice shards is really easy, especially because pretty much this area around here is filled with marines. Yeah, your sharp shooting skills, you're kind of dead for me, though, so I can't really use you. Right? Now, killing the commanding marine officer is always a good idea, because he can give the orders for everyone to fire at once. Right? That kills him. Still no cloth for me. Now, I need to watch out, because the beetle can also show up around here. Right? Dealing with all this around here. Okay, Gatling. Right? Just gotta kill everyone. Unfortunately, since on this island I can't use my SP freely, I'm stuck inside this sort of problem. And I keep on getting shot by you, and it's annoying. Right. Let's kill you. There we go. I got rid of you. Oh, gosh darn it. Let's switch characters to Zoro. All right, Zoro got comboed. I forgot about that. Let's switch to Robin. Right. I completely missed. I keep missing. All right. That should be the last of those bazooka ones, so the last one should be these gunners right here. Alright, that got rid of you. Never mind, it caused you to just spawn another one, so what is the absolute point? What is the point of this episode? Well, I got stuff to set up for the next boss. Unfortunately, I can't fight the next boss just yet. And a little bit more. There we go. That's all of them. Or not. Wait. You think that's all of them, and then one more shows up just to dick with you. And there we go. That should be the last one. Yep. So let us indeed move on. Go over here. See if we can find anything. Here's where you can put a trap for any of the animals you want. You have a chance of capturing a mammoth toad, or you could actually catch a beetle, which I can see one on the tree right over there. That's a little bit low. I hate it when it's low. Now, whenever it does that ice particle thing, don't swing at that time, because what'll end up happening is... Oh, come on! You have a chance of breaking your net. Luckily, I didn't break my net, but I just really wanted that stupid thing. But... Anyway, guys, I'm actually going to end it off right here. This has been Roxas1359. before we fight the boss for the next part, I'm going to build up my GP as well as catch everything that is necessary. And then we're going to head back to the Thousand Sunny, make ourselves the powered up vacuum, and get everything done in one fell swoop. So, see you guys next time.